Today I want to talk about my aquariums. More specifically, I want to talk about how I keep my aquariums. Okay, so I think it's obvious by now that you guys know I keep bare bottom aquariums. However, it has not always been that way. If you look at my oldest video here on YouTube, for example, you'll find that it is an aquascape tank. There's a 3D background in it that I built, there's substrate, and there's live plants. And there's actually a lot of little fish, including cardinal tetras and some rotkeel severums that I bred. Previous to that, that is basically how I used to keep a lot of my tanks. I was doing aquascapes, planted tanks, I was keeping a lot of different species of fish, and also even had a saltwater nano tank. But what has changed since then? Well, it was right around that time, perhaps a year or two before, I started getting into bigger fish, including freshwater stingrays. And when you get into the bigger fish and fish that are more exotic and or sensitive, like Asian arowana, freshwater stingrays, and discus, you tend to gravitate towards bare bottom aquariums. And when I first saw a bare bottom aquarium, I thought it looked horrendous. However, when you do it and why you should do it will definitely outweigh your feelings about it. I could even add that eventually it becomes an acquired taste and you will oddly prefer the look of a bare bottom aquarium. If you've been following me on Facebook and my live videos, I've been talking a lot about getting into fish, or getting back into fish, I should say, that I used to keep in the past, and getting back into aquascapes and that sort of thing. I often explain that my channel is basically a snapshot of where my hobby is at right now. It's not always been this way for me, with keeping bare tanks and big fish. However, I thought it was appropriate to talk about why I do it once again. I've actually covered this topic before a couple of years ago. My intentions here are to help you better understand bare bottom tanks. I am not trying to convince you to keep a bare bottom tank in any way. I just hope that moving forward, you'll have a better understanding of them. Now, typically speaking, bare bottom tanks are used for big fish, big tanks, delicate fish and or rare fish, breeding tanks, rearing tanks, grow out tanks, hospital tanks, quarantine tanks, and some just plain like a bare bottom aquarium. You'll even see a lot of reef tanks with bare bottom tanks. Now you can understand why you would do it on a quarantine tank or a hospital tank, because those are just temporary setups, so a substrate wouldn't be needed really. But why is it actually done on a lot of other tanks? Well, it really comes down to water quality. Having no substrate can contribute to having more consistent water quality. This is largely due to the ease of maintenance of a bare bottom tank. There literally is no maintenance of the tank with proper circulation. And because of that, there's no uneaten food getting trapped in the substrate, there's no detritus buildup, there's no low oxygen zones. But when it comes to a really big tank, having a substrate at first is great, but over time, it becomes more and more difficult to keep up with cleaning it. Now, I know many of you will never own large tanks like I have, but I can tell you that gravel vacuuming a tank that has over 30 square feet is no light task. There's actually a large array of reasons why bare bottom tanks are used, and it's generally depends on the fish that you're keeping and the reasons that benefit that species of fish. For example, since we're looking at my Asian arowana, there's no substrate in that tank for a few reasons, namely due to the ones we've already listed, but as you can tell, he doesn't need a substrate. He's literally just swimming at the top of the surface. It also makes it easier for him to collect food that's fallen to the bottom. Now, I won't get into single fish aquariums like this one, but to summarize it, the focus is always on the fish and not the decorations. Now, decorations is actually something we're gonna cover in a second. So to do a very basic summary of why there's no substrate, it just comes down to water quality, ease of maintenance, and to actually eliminate possible factors that could have a negative impact on the tank, which are really important when it comes to really sensitive and delicate fish and or really large fish and or really expensive fish. You don't want to risk harming the fish just to have a substrate. Now, some people might argue that fish need a substrate, and that is the case with some species of fish, but for the majority of them, they don't need it. In fact, for example, this fish was born in a mud pond and then raised in a bare tank. Most of your fish will come from farms which are raised in the same way and or raised in concrete vats and or bare tank situations as well, and the first time they come into contact with substrate would be at the pet store and or your tank. Now, this isn't a debate on whether it's natural or whether it looks better or anything like that. This is just a discussion as to why we do it in the first place. But why do some of these bear tanks also do no decorations? Well, almost for the same reasons as having no substrate. Sometimes a lot of decorations can also collect detritus and uneaten food and could lead to poor water quality. This obviously isn't a problem in most cases. However, it can happen. A lot of decorations can also take up a lot of real estate in the tank. And when you have big fish and or you have high stocking, real estate is really important. It also limits injuries. For example, if this guy had a piece of wood in the tank and he got scared or darted around, he could potentially break a fin, lose a scale, rip out a barbell, whatever the case may be. Not having that wood eliminates that possibility. Now, it might not sound like a big deal with your fish just getting hurt or getting a little scraped up, but when we start getting into fish that are valued at about $2,000, then it's a problem. Now, there are alternatives to substrate. For example, a lot of people like to use floor tiles, like porcelain tiles, on the bottom of your tank. You can get them in many designs and many colors, and a lot of the times they can mimic the look of having sand. Other people like to paint the bottom outsides of their tanks for the same effect. But then what's really popular is having a bare bottom tank, yet still having decorations, which is entirely possible. At the end of the day though, I know many hobbyists do not like bare tanks or bare bottom aquariums. However, I just wanted to let you guys know why we do it in the first place. Obviously, a decorated tank or a tank with substrate looks a lot better than a bare aquarium, but again, at least you now have a better understanding as to why it's happening in the first place. So moving forward, if you do see another bare bottom aquarium, you'll have a better idea as to why they might be doing that. I really felt as though I'd be a good person to talk about this because obviously many of you guys have seen my tanks, and throughout my entire channel's history, there's always been bare bottom aquariums and a lack of decorations. But again, my hobby has not always been like that, and it's not always going to be like that. As I mentioned earlier, we will be getting into a lot of smaller fish soon, and doing aquascapes and even planted aquariums, so I hope you guys stick around for that. I gotta say that I'm actually pretty excited to get back into aquariums like that. However, I'm not going to be giving up my big fish either. You might also be interested in the fact that I do a lot of live streaming on Facebook where I answer your questions, I show you some projects that I'm working on, give you a behind the scenes look at what I'm doing, and simply just interact with you guys on a more personal level. Links to my Facebook fan page will be in the description below. Anyways, I hope that you guys enjoyed today's video. If not, come back next week and I'll have something new for you.